Guys, welcome back to another video of Detroit Become Human. We are back. We are going to continue this awesome game. So let's go. November 6th. We start with the detectives, android and human.
Oh, hey! Plastic with you.
I need to make peace.
How you doing? Hey, listen, I got a shit hot tip for you. Number 5 in the 3rd. Lickety split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser. You want a flutter?
Last shit hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong.
I'm in.
Damn straight. Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
Sorry for my behavior back at the police station. I didn't mean to be unpleasant.
Oh, wow. You've even got a brown nose and apology program. As if CyberLife thought everything, huh? Here you go.
Don't leave that thing here.
Huh, not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
This Pedro? He was proposing illegal gambling. Am I right?
Yeah. I'm sorry.
And
guys.
You made a bet.
I'm a bit sick.
Yeah.
Your meal contains 1.4 times the recommended daily intake of calories, and twice the cholesterol level. You shouldn't eat that.
Everybody's gotta die of something.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought.
This morning, when we were chasing those deviants, why didn't you want me to cross the highway?
Because you could have been killed. And I don't like filling out paperwork for damaged equipment.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why did they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I'm focused on the case, Lieutenant. The rest doesn't concern me. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. You should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Connor,
you run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Now, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
This place stinks. Well, looks like we came for nothing. Our man's gone. Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a note, but it's indecipherable. Probably initials.
Look
put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom...
The driver's license is fake.
Cool. This didn't come for nothing.
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons.
Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something. I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some. Electronic books, you can't.
Thank you.
We had it! Fuck!
It's my fault. I should have been faster.
You'd have caught it if it weren't for me. That's all right. We know what it looks like. We'll find it. Hey, Connor. Nothing.
Whoa, great chase. Awesome. Awesome. Oh, yeah. This game has some awesome details. Oh, well. We didn't catch him, but we will catch it next time. I'm sure. Now, back to this one.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
I don't understand. I thought Jericho was a place where androids lived in freedom.
We do live in freedom. It may not be what you hoped for, but here we have no master. We don't belong to anybody.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
This is Jericho?
It's a refuge for those who don't want to be slaves anymore. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Humans were your masters, and now it's fear that rules you. You're no freer than you ever were. You've only found a new master.
You're lost. Just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
The android that tell the other android that there was a safe place.
I'm not in very good shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
After death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
was glad to meet you, Marcus.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. I'll stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
How long have you been here?
4 weeks, 3 days, 11 hours. When I escaped, there was nowhere else to go. Jericho seemed as good a place as any.
Who found this place?
Nobody knows anymore. Whoever he was, his body's probably lying somewhere on this boat. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
They threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. Cyberlife Warehouse is in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in.
Okay. some help here. Soon this will all be just a bad memory. This is the place. Zlatko?
Who's asking?
I was told you could help us.
I don't know who told you that. You came to the wrong place. I'm sorry.
Wait. We really need your help.
Come in. Don't be shy. Luther, would you be so kind as to take these ladies' coats? Don't be afraid of our big friend here. Luther is just another android that I helped. He keeps me company in this big, empty old house. Please, make yourselves at home. How did you hear about me?
An android. On the street, he said you could help us.
I see. Deviant, huh? What about her?
She's human.
And you want to find a safe place. Somewhere you can start a new life. I hear Canada is very lovely at this time of year. Beautiful landscapes, open spaces, clean air, and no android laws. Great place for a fresh start.
Yes, that's exactly what we want.
Of course. I can help you. But first, we have to get rid of your tracker.
Tracker?
Yeah. All androids are fitted with a tracking device to locate them at all times. I'll remove yours, and then you'll both be safe. Come on. Follow me. The little one can wait for us in the living room.
No, she always stays with me.
Of course. Right this way? Everything we need is in the basement.
I don't like this place, and that man. Let's go, I have a bad feeling.
It'll be okay, Alice. He's going to remove my tracker, and then we can start over again in Canada. You want that too, right?
Please excuse the mess. I need it somewhere discreet for my machines. Removing trackers is illegal, so I opted for discretion over comfort. I hope the little one isn't too scared.
No. No, she'll be all right.
That's good.
Come on, Alice.
This way, please. If you could just stand over there. I should warn you, this could be quite unpleasant. You know what's strange? For some unknown reason, the trackers seem to stop working in Deviants. That's why it's so hard to find them. So, actually, there's no reason to remove your tracker.
What? But you said that...
Yeah, people believe what they want. You Deviants are so naive. They'll come to me expecting me to help them. And I just reset them, sell them on. Or I keep them for my little experiments.
No! No! I don't want to be reset! Let me go!
Ah! Oh, I forgot about the child. Lock it up. I'll deal with it later.
Alice! Alice, no!
Wow. A deviant that wants to be a mother. That's so sweet. And so deluded. I think it's time we put you out of your misery. That's what you get for having a dream. It always ends up the same way. Tears and disillusionment. Believe me, you're better off being erased and feeling nothing. No more pain. No more hopes dashed. I almost envy you.
Kara!
Oh, poor little Alice. Oh, looks like Mommy doesn't remember you at all, huh?
Looks like Mommy's completely forgotten you.
Carl, what happened to you?
Oh, all right, that's enough. Come on.
You bit me. I'm gonna teach you some manners, you little bitch.
Meet me in the living room.
Monsters for his amusement. But who's the real monster? Look what he did to us.
Yes, Locko.
I should be done here in 10 minutes or so. I'll have a look at the little one, see what I can do with it.
Understood, Locko. I'll bring you the little one in 10 minutes.
are you doing here? Has the Master authorized you to be here? You must always obey the Master. Oh yes, you must always obey. You should not be here. What are you doing? You're not gonna hurt me. No. No. No, you wouldn't do that.
I'm looking for a little girl. Have you seen her?
A little girl? No, no, no. I haven't seen her.
No. No, of course not. We have to go. Follow me and don't make any noise, okay?
Luther! Yes, Zarko.
I'm finished here. Go fetch the little one.
Right away, Zarko.
Disappeared. Gotta be here somewhere. What are you waiting for? Go look.
point in running? You can't escape from me. You. Dreams always end in tears. You should have listened to me. What are you doing? Get out of my way.
No. Not this time.
I said get out of my way or I'll shoot right through you. What are you doing? Who let you out? Get away from me! Get away from me! Obey me! I'm your master! I'm your master!
I saw the little one risk her life to save you. It was like opening my eyes for the first time. Finally, I could see. I know you have no reason to trust me after what I did. But I knew someone who could help you across the border. I could take you there. I could protect you. You and the little one.
All right. I trust you.
Hey, wake up.
I was so scared of losing you.
Alright guys, we reached the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoy it. See you next video. Bye bye.